How's it going, troglodytes? Today I'm going to teach you guys how I personally clean fretboards as well as polish the frets up. Today we're going to be working on a Zach Wild Les Paul custom. First, you're going to want to remove your strings. That way you have complete access. You can just loosen the tension and get them off the fretboard if your strings don't need changing. But as you can see, this fretboard definitely needs some attention. You can see all the dirt and grime built up that's been scraped away by bending. And you can see the frets have just lost their luster. And there's a big rust spot area right there. We are going to cure this guitar of these ailments. For this job, you will need some grade quadruple zero steel wool. This is very fine stuff. It's not going to hurt the guitar. Despite what a lot of people might say, there's a lot of misconceptions about using steel wool on guitar. Trust me, I've been doing it for years, it's just fine. And you'll need some type of fretboard conditioner. I like to use this Dunlop 65 lemon oil. It's not really pure lemon oil, it's very diluted down, but it definitely helps your fretboard out. But you're free to use whatever oil that you prefer. You're going to want to start by cutting off a small piece of steel wool. It just kind of unravels like this. I usually just go one layer and I cut straight across. I usually cut it in half one more time. And now you're good to go. Some people tape off the fretboard at this part. I find when you're using such fine grade stuff, it doesn't really affect the wood. So you're just going to take this and rub it against the fret and try not to hit too much of the wood and just get it on the fret as well as you can. You're going to see that after just a few strokes, mainly everything is going to come off that fret. As you can see, that is a much shinier looking fret. It's going to play a lot better now. So you're going to continue that process all the way down the fretboard. Now that that's completed, you can see that all the frets are nice and shiny now. That's going to make them play a lot smoother and just make the guitar more enjoyable to play in general. Next is the fretboard. I do the exact same thing. You can either use the same one if you still have enough steel wool, or you can use that other half we used. Now with this one, you're going to want to go with the grain of the wood. That way you're not scalloping your guitar. But you just go up and down the neck. Just like so. This will kind of remove most of the dirt and grime that's built up as you've been playing. Sometimes there's a little bit of area of gunk here. What I like to do is I take my nail under the steel wool and I just very lightly go back and forth there to get some of that extra gunk out. So we're going to go ahead and do that for every fret now. Then, once you completed all that, I found you can give everything a good once-over again by just running the steel wool up and down the neck. It kind of helps get any of the extra gunk out of there. You might want a new piece for this. You just do it like this. Now you're going to look at your fretboard and go, oh my gosh, Trogly, what did you just do to this very beautiful guitar? You just destroyed the fretboard. It looks terrible. It looks gray. What did you do to my ebony fretboard? Why did I listen to you? This is where this magic stuff comes in. Let's watch it do its work. You simply take off the cap, like so, and that has an applicator right on it, and you just run it up and down just like you did with your steel wool up and down the neck. I already saved us the time and did it all the way up and down the neck, so after that, you need to wait anywhere from, 5 to 20 minutes just to let it soak in and do its work. From here, I dry up the excess oil with a paper towel. I usually run along the grain of the wood. That way it kind of helps massage it in, as well as remove any excess dirt that we might have missed during the rest of the cleaning process. And you'll be surprised at just how much stuff comes off of even guitars that look really clean. I mean, look at this, that's a lot of dirt. And I usually run it over one or two times. If you're still not happy with the way your board looks, sometimes I will do a second or sometimes even a third coating, but one time usually does it. You don't have to wipe up all of the extra oil. It will eventually dry on its own. Now that the whole cleaning process is done, I hope you see how much better this fretboard looks. It's much healthier, less prone to cracking, and most importantly, plays better. Feel free to share the way you like to clean your guitar in the comments below. Alright, Troglodytes, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you on the next episode. Take care.